Janvasya Jnanam Janasalabhya Chakshurvitam Tasmai Sri Gurave Vanchakalpatarubhyasya Kripasindhubhyeva cha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namo Mahabhadannaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namne Gauratmise Namo Gurave Gaura Chandraya Radhikaya Itadaya Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya Tadabhaktaya Namo Yang Praprajantamanupetamapetakritya Dvaipayano Virahakataryadha Utreti Tanmayatayatar Bhoginedu Tan Sarvabhutari Dayam Munimana Prasno Tavai Vasmi Najivami Sayadha Iti Millions of Dandot Pranati into the lotus feet of my spiritual master Nitya Leela Pravishth Om Vishnu Pad Sutta Shishmat Bhakti Pradhyan Keshav Goswami Maharaj and same millions of Dandot Pranati Pushpanjali in the lotus feet of my Shiksha Guru Nitya Leela Pravishth Om Vishnu Pad Sutta Bhakti Pradhyan Swami Maharaj.
首先我向我的灵性导师 Nityalila Pravishtha Om Vishnu Pad Astota Sata Shishma Bhakti Pragyana Keshava Goswami 的莲花烛献上无限的鲜花礼以及顶拜同样我也向我的训示灵性导师 Nityalila Pravishtha Om Vishnu Pad Astota Sata Shishma Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj 的莲花烛自予了无数的顶拜
Yesterday in the class we told that how by the inspiration of Devarshi Narad Vyasdev in trance in Samadhi he saw all the three pastimes of Krishna Purna Brahma and he saw that those who are forgetting Krishna they are going to this world, birth after birth they are suffering and those who are doing bhajan, they are going to Vaikuntha and Golok Vrindavan and searching Krishna in heart. Then he wrote all the sweet pastimes of Krishna and the life history of all the Vaishnavas, like Prahlad Maharaj and others. And he wrote Srimad Bhagavatam. Those who are, they don't know the glory of Krishna for them. And he taught it to his disciple, Shukadeva Goswami, who told Srimad Bhagavat in Parikshit Kaunse. We have described it. But today is also very auspicious day because one of the Vaishnava Acharya, Parama Bhakta and highly cultured and realized so Ramanujacharya birthday today. Ramanuja, a great devotee and great acharya.
那么，在开课之前，我们昨天已经讲到了Narada如何呢？训示Vyasa，而在Vyasa在Samadhi中呢，看到了Krishna甜美的逍遥时光。 那么那些忘记 Krishna 的人来到这个世界，生生世世受苦，而做出八正灵修的人，他们可以到的 Vaikuntha 以及 Goloka 服务 Krishna。由此 ，Vyasa 写下了 Krishna 的逍遥时光，以及 Vaishnava 的生平，像 Prada 大军等等。他就此完成盛典佛教法坛，对于给予那些不知道 Krishna 知觉，就是不知道 Krishna 的人，他传授了Sukadeva Goswami 盛典佛教法堂，而 Sukadeva Goswami 又传授了 Parikshit 大军。那么今天也是一个非常吉祥的日子，是我们传系上一位伟大的 Acharya Ramanuja Acharya 的显现日。
Sri Ramanuja came in a very rusticated and religious family. Father and mother both were very religious minded.
Ramanuja Acharya 来自一个非常高贵的家族，也是非常虔诚的家族。那么他父母双人的话呢，都非常的虔诚。
From beginning of his life, Ramanuja was very, very intelligent.
那么在人生之初的话呢 Ramanuja 都非常的有智慧。
The astrologer came to him when he was baby and saw that the sentence in Ramanuja is like Lakshman, the brother of
Lord Ram.
Sri Ramchandra. And that is why he named that boy Lakshman Desi. Lakshman Desi.In the boyhood, he read Sanskrit and everything. And then he went to a Mayabad Sannyasi Jadwacharya to study Vedanta Shastra.
Ramanuja 出生的时候，星象家已经看过他的星宫图，他具有非常非凡的这个呢星宫图的布阵，所以呢命他为呢 Lakshman Desi。那么在孩童时候呢，他已经精通梵文，去到一位呢这个 speech master。
As I told that from boyhood he was very very intelligent and very scholar. So one day his guru Jadav Prakash.Any disciple came to him and asked Jadav Prakash, what is the meaning of Kapyasam in Chandogya Upanishad?
Kapyasam Kundari Kaksam.
那么当时呢这一位呢他的灵性导师 Jadav Prakashaya 的话呢非常有学识的，所以很多呢人呢向他询问呢 Chandogya Upanishad 的这个奥义，这个书
Then Jadwacharya answered, Kapyasang means a monkey's
backside
means two-third, as red is the monkey's heap of Vishnu.
Eyes
are red as that.
India monkeys are red.
那么但是他们像那个 Jagaprakash 的话呢询问一个师姐的，其中有一段的话呢，那个意思呢Jagaprakash 这样解释的他说主 Vishnu 的这个莲花眼呢，红得像那个猴子的那个屁股
Shankaracharya for this word has.Explain. Same thing. So he was telling what Shankaraj had told. But tears came in the eyes of Ramanu. And it fell on the feet of Jadwacharya because he was
massaging
his Gurudev.
He was massaging. He was crying.
那么当时的话呢 Ramanuja 哈在给他的灵性导师按摩这个莲花足了，他听了这种解释之后呢，那么这种解释当然是依照哈 Sankarachaya 的这个解释了，所以他的啊眼泪呢就滴下来哈，掉到了这他的灵性导师的这个哈腿上。
Then at once Yadvacharya told why you are weeping. Then he told, I'm weeping that you have done wrong explanation of this compassion. Oh, you know better than Shankaracharya, he has done this. He told Gurudev.He has done wrong. Then he told that, I said, you should explain it. Then boldly he told, Kapyasam, ka mane sun, asam mane pivati.
Drinking.
Kapyasam means who?
Drinks the sun.
Pivati, arthat.
Ko jalam.
Ko jalam.
Pivati.
Drink. Awesome.
Awesome to spread and illuminate.
So, this meaning is that Kapyasam means kamal.
Lotus.
To whom when sun rises, then
lotus
become.And that is why the eyes of the Vishnu is as lotus flower.
As beautiful and ready.
That.
那么加德川雅的话呢，就当时呢就询问他哈，说你为什么要哭？他说你对 Vyasa 的哈这个师姐的话呢有一些错误的解释。那么他的灵性导师就说，那是不是你比我哈对 Sankarachaya 的话呢有更好的哈这个理解呢？他说你来阐述一下。那么当时的话呢 Ramanuja 呢就解释了哈 Kapyasa 的意思呢，他说是莲花的意思，那么就像太阳哈出来莲花呢开放，所以主的眼睛呢上了哈这个盛放的莲花。
Jado Prakash then became very
angry
and he thoughtIf he will be alive, then he will cut the argument of Shankar and Mayabad philosophy. That is why he wanted to finish his life. One day also, king of that kingdom,The wife of that king was attacked by any host. And then king called Yadavacharya to rebuke that host. He went there. Lakhan was also with him. Oh, he uttered mantra that he should go away.But the host told, you don't know anything, and he rebuked him and told, by your mantra I will not go. If Ramanuj,
Lakshman Desi,
feet wash water, if I will be given, I will go away. Then king,Wash the feet of
Lakshman
Desi and gave it to that
host.
Queen.
Princesses, Rajkumari.
And at once, host.
Ran away from there.
He was liberated.
Now, then, his spiritual teacher, Jagat Prakash, 的话呢，很生气了。他说呢，如果他活着，然后他会阻挡的这三卡山啊，这个 Chaya 这个教导，并且会令到这个传系呢哈毁灭，所以呢要就是要谋杀他。那么当时呢，那个国王的妻子呢哈被那个鬼附身了哈，去缠啊，然后呢他请了他的灵性导师呢去哈驱鬼了。 那么他唱诵这个曼陀罗、哦、要将那个鬼、哦、赶走，但是那鬼说、哦、你什么都不懂的，所以呢你唱的曼陀罗、哦、我你唱的这个曼陀罗的话呢我是不会离开的，所以他要那个 Lakshman、Lakshman Dish 这个木竹水。他说那么后来国王呢就给这个 Lakshman Dish、哦、木竹，并且呢将这个木竹水给予他的妻子、哦、这个王妃呢饮下，然后呢这个鬼呢得以解脱，然后呢就走了哈。
Then Jada Prakash made a plan to kill him. He declared that he will go to Prayag to take bath in Triveni Ganges. And then all the, his disciples were ready to go with him and he told Lakhan Desik that you also come with me. His plan was in heavy forest. Anyhow, we will finish him. But Kuresh,
Govinda,
material brother,
Govinda,
as in brother, Govinda, he told Ramanu, you should run away from here at once.
Tonight they kill you.
It was night. You should run away, otherwise you will be killed. Then Ramanuj at once run away from there. Running, he went in a forest under a tree he was resting. After some time, Govind went to Gurudev. Gurudev asked, where is Ramanuj?
Lakshman
Desi. He told, oh, he has come before me, but I'm not seeing where he is. Then Jadav Prakash thought that any animal, tigers, has killed him. So he became very happy. This Ramanuj then saw
a
wife and husband. They were jungly tribes. And then Ramanuj told where you are going. They told them we are going to Kanjivaram. Oh, I'm also going. And by the light of Harikan, they went there. After some time, they vanished. And Ramanu saw that, oh, I have reached to Kanjivaram, very far away, about 4 months traveling. And he was in one night, he and did pranam to Bharadaraj. When Jadav Prakash returned and he saw Ramanuj, oh, I outwardly he told, I'm very happy that you are safe. Again, you should come and study with me. Ramanuj was Vaishnav, so he again began.
Now, the spiritual teacher, Jada Prakash, planned to kill Ramanuj. Now, he pretended to go Yeah. 那么去掉恒河沐浴，所以他呢要求所有的门徒、哦、都随他一同去，也叫上呢 Lakshman Dish。 那么在穿过密林的时候呢，他想设计要、啊、杀掉他，所以他叫，但是呢其中他一个门徒的话呢就告诉 Lakshman Dish 说呢，你今晚、哦、赶快走吧，因为他们要把你杀掉。所以 Lakshman Dish 的话呢一路呢、哦、就是说奔跑。后来呢他的灵性导师询问了其中一位、啊、门徒、啊、叫 Govinda，他说他在哪、嗯、那么 Govinda 就说了、哦、他走在我前面不知道、哦、那么他的灵性老师呢就以为、哦、他可能会在这个森林里面、哦、被其他动物呢所吃掉，所以 那么当时呢 Lakshman Dish 在呢在林中、哦、看到一对呢打猎的夫妇，那么就询问他们、哦、去往这个恒河的那个这个路径的， asking about where?
Kanchipur.
那么去 Kanchipur 这个地方，那么地方呢已经是很远的，有大概有四个月的行程才能够走到的。但是呢，他一夜就能够到。那么他回去的时候呢，他的灵性导师哦看到他，假装也很高兴的哦。但是呢 ，Ramanuja 作为一个 Vaishnava 哈，他不计较这东西哈，依然呢在他的师门下哈学习。
Anyhow, a big history. I'm telling very short.Jamunacharya, who was last alvar of Sri Sampradaya, he heard the glory of Raman and he wanted that after me he should be Vaishnavacharya. And he sent his very qualified Vaishnava to him and Mahapurna.And then he went there and he, Ramanuj, now thinking that I must give the worldly
life
and I should go to my guru
Jamunacharya
and I will take sannyas from him. In the meantime,He was like a adhyapak,
as a professor
of his school. One day, a Brahmin came and told, I'm very hungry, you should give me something. And then he told that, go to my home, my wife will give you. But wife rebuked that Brahmin and did not give anything. Then he returned back.Then he wrote a letter from as if the wife's Ramanujacharya father is inviting her that there is my son's marriage and you should come very soon. Then he wrote letter and something he gave.Coconut and he went. At that time, his wife honored so much and gave so many delicious foods. And then he told Ramanuj, she told that my father has called me because my brother's marriage is there. Then he became very happy and told him, you should go with all your ornaments. I will come later on.And thus, forever, she went to her father and he left the world and went to Sri Rangam. And in the way he saw that Jamunacharya has left his body. Then he went there and told that I want to see my Gurudev face and body.They showed him his three fingers were like this and only one leg. Then Ramanuj, knowing his wish, he promised that I will write a Sri Bhashya of Vedanta Sutra. Then,One came. And then he told, I will preach whole world mission of your Jamunacharya. Then second and third.
I will name a disciple after Parasa Rishi.
Third.
I will name one disciple after Parasa Rishi.
Anyhow, three. And then three came. Then all saw that Ramanuj actually the disciple of Srila Ramanujacharya. And then there he took sannyas and became preacher of Sri Sampradaya Ramanu.
那么呢，这是一个很长的一个历史故事哦。就当时的这个故事，那么Shri的故事呢，只是简短的讲了一下。那么当时在世的Ramanujan的这个故事，所以很想他继任作为呢他那个传系人Shri Sampradaya的这个呢Acharya，所以呢他派了一个高阶的Vaishnava去到他那里。那么Ramanujan呢，很想当时呢就很想着，我一定要想放弃这个世俗生活了。 去接受我的，去到我的guru哈，Ramanujan那里，从他那里接受 sannyas。 所以有一天的话，有一个婆罗门来到他家里面，他说我很饿哈，我想要点东西吃。那么 Ramanujan 说你去我家里面吧，我妻子会给你的。但是呢，他妻子呢并没有给呢这个婆罗门呢布施任何呢吃的。所以 Ramanujan 呢就写了一封信，假托他妻子的父亲写了一封信给他妻子，说。 他的儿子呢想结婚了哈，请他的这个女儿呢回去参加这个婚礼。那么他的妻子呢就对Ramanujan哈就说了，说我的兄弟要结婚了啊，你跟我一起走哈，我们一起回去。那么Ramanujan就说哈，你先走哈，带上所有的这些呢哈装，就是说你的打扮那些饰品，你先走，我呢哈后面走。所以在他妻子走后的话呢，他实际上呢哈就永远离弃了他的这个家庭生活，前往呢。 Sri Lanka哈这个地方，那么在路上他已经知道Yamanujacharya哈已经呢隐迹了，所以他执意要看一下他的灵性导师哈Yamanujacharya的这个呢身体。当时发现呢他的灵性导师哈三个手指哈还是合着的，也就是说呢哈他还有一些哈愿望没有实现，所以他就地呢承诺了三个做了三个承诺。第一个呢是Vedanta哈。
Vedanta，explanation。那么第一个呢是对呢维丹塔经的这个注释，第二个呢是他愿意去呢全世界传教承诺去全世界传教还有第三个呢，那么最后的话呢就是说他说完一个愿望的承诺完一个的话呢，他灵性导师一个手指呢就会张开，最后呢他说完三个之后呢，他的灵性导师三指都张开了。 也就这样子的话呢，Ramanujan实际上是呢Yamunacharya真正的门徒，他就地呢接受了呢这个 sannyasi， 成为 Sri Sampradaya 那个时代那个传承的这个伟大的 Acharya。
After that he wrote Sri Parsha。 According to Bodhayan, Tanka, and their notes. And then he traveled whole South India. He came to Dwarka, he came to Kashi, and he went to Jagannath Puri, and he went to Vrindavan Mathura also. Everywhere. He went to Badrikasram also and preached everywhere. But in South India there was a king who was Shaiva. He saw that all Shaiva will are going to be Vaishnav. So he was very angry and called him. But Kuresh, he is one of his disciples. He told him, I will go, you should not go. They will kill you. They should kill me no harm. And then he took the danda and sannyas of Ramanuj and went there. And they had planned to kill. So they discussed something, Saiva Tattva and Vaishnav Tattva. Kuresh defeated them, but yet they clapped. We are winning, and they took the eyes of Kuresh out. Then he became blind, and then Kuresh went. went searching his Gurudev where he is. And in the meantime, Ramanuj was
preaching
very far away from Sri Rangam, anywhere. And he went to his one disciple, Bharadaraj. Was very poor. When Ramanuj went there with so many disciples, hundreds of disciples, then that Brahma was not in house, he had gone to bake something. And his wife was alone in house. But his clothes were very
worn
and torn. She could not come in front of Ramanuj. Then Ramanuj gave his chadar and wrapped and then she saw that, hundreds of disciples are Ramanuj has come here. What to do? How to respect them? What to feed? Then he remembered a very rich person,
businessman,
he's a neighbor. He has bad
motive
towards me. He wants to enjoy me. And he has told that I will give so much money to you. But up till now, she refused. Now today he told, he was thinking, what is this use of this body if I cannot serve my Gurudev? No need of chastity, nothing. She went to that rich person and told that my Gurudev with so many disciples have come. You should give me chawal, dal, atta and ghee and so many things, paraphernalia, and I will cook and feed my Gurudev. He became very happy. Today, in night she will come and get so many things. She went to her house and cooked and feed his Gurudev. In the meantime, Brahman came and asked, my Gurudev has come with so many disciples. How to feed them? Today I had nothing in begging. He was thinking, in the meantime, his wife told that, I have everything done, I have fed them, and they are now resting, don't worry.
那么这里面讲到的话，一个就是呢，罗曼努者呢，在接受了这个体力之后的话呢，写下了Shri Pasha这本书哦，最后他在南印度，周游南印度，多卡、喀什、加格纳普里、温达文、马图罗哈，还有等等地啊，还有喀什米尔等等地呢传教。那么在南印度的话呢，当时有希瓦的这些追随者。 有个国王支持了这些呢追随者的，他想的如果呢，Ramanuja这么有影响力的话呢，那么所有的这个希瓦的教徒呢，都会成为呢Vaishnava。所以呢，他们就挑战了这些，就是挑战的Ramanuja这个门派了。那么当时Ramanuja派了他的一个门徒呢，Kulash前往呢，就是说应变了。那么当时在那个法会上的话呢。 他们讨论了经典，而实际上呢，是呢，Ramanuja的这个门徒呢 ，Kulash 的话呢，赢得了这场辩论。但是因为当时的话呢，对方的话呢，就把他的眼睛就是弄瞎了，所以他就此的话呢，失去了跟他的灵性导师的这个关系。而 Ramanuja 呢，也远在他地，然后呢，他与他的门徒呢，到达了一个村庄。 当地呢有个婆罗门非常的穷了，那么 Ramanuja 这么多门徒一到他家里面，他没有了东西给他们吃。 那么他的衣服很烂的哈，当时就没有衣服出门哈。当时罗摩努贾呢就将自己的一块布的话呢哈，就给他了，以让他哈蔽，就是以用以蔽体了。那么他的妻子呢，当时有一个当地的一个很有钱的人呢，很喜欢他妻子，但是呢被他的妻子拒绝了。这时候呢，罗摩努贾因为到他们家里面，他们没有东西招待，所以他妻子想起了这个钱人，他觉得如果呢我不能够。